Hey, so this is part two in a series on how to design presentations really, really quickly and really, really easily. And in the first video, I kind of talked about how to really narrow down your topic and focus on something more specific that makes it a lot easier, and then create your presentation outline. On this video, we're going to show you how to take that outline and turn it into this phenomenal presentation. So stay tuned. Hi, this is Doug Stannert with Fearless Presentations, the fastest, easiest way to eliminate public speaking fear. And on this video, we're going to show you how to take a presentation outline and really jazz it up, put some meat on the bone, so to speak. And there are a few different things that you want to do in order to kind of take your outline and turn it into a really good presentation. The concept that I like to use, the analogy I like to use is you want to pretend like you're an attorney and you're making a case to your jury. And so your audience, the people that you're speaking to, is your jury. So if you're trying to prove something to them, then your bullet points are the concepts that you're trying to prove. And then you add in what we call impact ideas, or things that will take that bullet point and prove that that bullet point is true. Hey, so just so you know, in our Fearless Presentations class, we identify 10 things that you can do to add impact to any presentation. We're gonna focus on three of those in this video because they're the three that are the most, I don't wanna say the most useful, but they're the ones that you can use in just about any type of presentation. So they're the one that are kind of the most universal, I guess, is probably the best way to explain it. And so if you really wanna add some meat to your presentation, you probably wanna use at least these three things, if not some of the other 10 that are in the Fearless class. But the number one, the main thing that you wanna add into your presentation is, once you've got that good outline, go to each one of those bullet points and try to identify a specific real life example, a story, something that has happened in real life related to this bullet point. So for instance, in the last video, we kind of talked about a sample presentation that we were designing where the Midwest region had this really bump in revenue, and we identified that the reason why they did that was because they were focusing on repeat business from customers. So out of the 3 months where the Midwest region was really focusing on doing that business with repeat customers, let's say one of the sales reps, Bill, was advised or asked to make 10 phone calls a day for 7 days just to see what would come of it. And in one of those days, he made a single phone call to a customer that loved us but hasn't heard from us in 3 or 4 months. And that customer ended up buying $20,000 in products from us. So if all I have to do is use that as an example, that was real life. Bill actually did that. He called the client. The client actually bought from us. And I can use that as an example to prove that my first bullet point is true. The more details that we put into these stories, the more details that we put in the examples, the more interesting it is and the more relatable we are to the audience. So it's a fun way to kind of put content into your presentation. So stories are by far the one highest, biggest, greatest, most fantastic way to add impact to your presentation. The second thing that you can do is you can add a quote, like a well-timed quote from an expert. If you can add a quote in, you're actually borrowing the credibility from the person who you're quoting. So like for instance, if I want to tell people that they want to condense their content and their presentation down to a much shorter format, you know, a lot of times people get too wordy in their presentations, I might use a quote from Ira Hayes. Ira Hayes was the person who said, you know, nobody ever got upset when a presentation went too long, right? So I can just quote that successful speaker and use and borrow Ira Hayes' credibility when I give my presentation. And you can do the same thing. The easiest way to do this, by the way, is whatever concept that you're trying to get across to your audience, type those words or that concept into Google and just put the word quote at the end of it. There's a good chance somebody out there has created a web page with 10, 15, 20, 30, 40, 50, 100, 2,000 different quotes about that specific topic. It's a real easy thing to do. Now, the key thing is that you have to kind of remember the quote. A lot of times what presenters will do is they will take that quote and they'll put it on a slide just so they don't forget it. Remember that when you do that, you're now losing a lot of that impact that you have. When you're able to quote an expert, people think of you as being smart now. because I'm quoting people that are experts at this. If I have to read it off of a slide, now it doesn't have nearly as much impact. So story is really important, and then the quote is also really important. The third thing, which is really helpful and really adds a lot of fun to your presentations and makes the presentation way more memorable to the people in the audience, is to insert analogies. For instance, at the beginning of this video, I mentioned that you want to pretend like you're an attorney and you're presenting your case to the jury. That's an analogy. I'm basically comparing designing a presentation to designing a case to the jury, right? So when you compare those two things, although they're somewhat related because of the differences that are between the two, it makes it much more interesting for the audience. So think about something that you can compare the bullet point that you're trying to get across to the audience to. And if you can compare it to something that's totally different or totally unique, it makes it more fun for them. Like for instance, one of the analogies that we use in our Fearless Presentations classes a lot of times is that we want to show people that they're capable of way more than what we give ourselves credit for. And we use what we call the iceberg analogy. And you've probably seen this before. But basically what we're showing people is that psychologists tell us in our entire lifetimes we're only going to use or develop about 10% of our potential. They say it's like looking at an iceberg. When you look at an iceberg above the surface, there's only about 10% of that showing. 90% of the iceberg is hidden below the surface. And they say it's the same with us. 90% of our potential is hidden within us. So when we use that analogy in our classes, it makes it much more interesting for the audience because they're actually creating that visual image in their mind as I describe it to them. They're actually seeing the big chunk of ice on top of the water and then going, you know, mentally going underneath the water to see the big, huge, bigger chunk of ice that's underneath. And so it makes it much more interesting. It's in engaging a different part of the brain for the people that are in your audience, and they'll like you a whole lot more. So when you're wanting to put more meat on your presentation, if you want to make the presentation really have a lot of impact, basically add some stories in there, add a quote or two, add an analogy every now and then. If you do that, you're going to have these fantastic presentations that people are going to absolutely love. Hey, make sure and subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet done so. And actually leave me a comment as well. So if you've used this technique, if you've actually created your outline and then used these impact ideas to help you create a better presentation, or if you've gone over to fearlesspresentations.com and used our speech creator, leave a comment below and let us know how this has actually worked for you.